Welcome. In this video I'm going to show you how you can create a multiple response set in Excel. I'm using as an example some cinemas in Amsterdam, four of them, and a zero represents here that someone didn't visit the cinema and a one that he or she did. The first thing to do is to remove actually any cases where you have one or more missing values. Now in this example I actually don't have any, so I don't need to, but if for example one would be missing, you would be able to simply select the entire row and then right click and then say delete. If you don't want to delete your data, what you can also do, I'll make this a little bit smaller, come back to it later, is to use a formula. That is actually, I'll type it in once, it's also there to the right, which actually does the following. It's the if function, then open the parentheses, and then you use count. And what you actually want to see is count how many times there's something in this array. Then press the F4 F4 key to select the dollar signs just only in front of the column letters. That way, if we copy it to the side or down, it will not adjust the A and the D. That's in my example because I have four. Close those parentheses, then semicolon or comma, depending on your system settings. And the value should be the same as the number of variables, so in this case four. So if count if, oh sorry, no semicolon, equals four, then, or the number of variables that you have, then it should simply return the value and otherwise nothing, which can be accomplished by twice the quotation signs then close the parentheses. So this 4 is simply the number of variables that you have. I have 4. If you had a fifth cinema, for example, then it would have been 5. Then you can press enter or control enter and then you can copy paste this formula to the side. Then for everything else that, and down of course. Then for everything else I'm going to show you, you can then use these columns instead of these. Now in my case there is no difference, so I'll be using these. Just want to show you how you can accomplish step one in a few different ways. Step two is then determine the value you want to actually count. Well, in this case I want to see how many people did visit something, so that was coded as a one, so I'm entering a one. Now note that if you had coded like 1 is no and 2 is yes, for example, then you might want to add the 2's in there. Then determine the total number of valid cases. In my case that's simply there for the count of any of the columns, so in my case column A, assuming there's nothing above or below that entire column. Or I could have done column M. In my case there wouldn't be a difference. I have 150 people that answered all 4 questions, or actually ticked boxes in there. Then the frequencies is simply in this case the sum, or actually it's the count. So is count if open parentheses column A, and then the criteria is the value that we actually wanted to count. Press F4 and then so that the dollar signs get in there, enter, and there were 81 people who selected the munt. Can copy paste this down, then it will simply say 81 everywhere because it's still column A. Double click on it and then you can actually drag this one to column B, enter, double click again or press F2, then move it to column C, and then last but not least for the arena it's all the way to the side, and there we go. You can add in here the sum of these. You can also press Alt equals then, and then we'll actually automatically enter it in. So there are 244 answers given. I had 150 people who gave 244 answers. If I wanted to know the percentage based on the number of responses, so how many answers were given, it's going to be simply the 81 divided by, and then this total. Again, F4 so it gets blocked. Enter or control enter to see the result. I want to see this as a percentage, which you can actually do on the home ribbon and then simply select here the percentage sign. And then I can copy paste this one down. You can use control C, control V or the autofill handle and double click on one of them just to make sure it's really doing what it's supposed to do. So this tells me that 25% of the answers given was actually for Tuschinski. Now I'm more interested in how many people, so the percentage of people that actually visited, which is the percent of cases. So in this case that would be the same as the 81, but now divided over the 150. Again, press F4 or enter the dollar signs manually, enter or control enter, change it into a percentage at the home, and then there is the percentage, and then you can copy paste this down to see all the percentages. So double click again just on one of them to see if everything's going okay. So 41% of the respondents visited Tuschinski. Now as the last thing, if you want to see this as a nice bar chart, what you can do is select cinema until the last one, then press the control key percent till the last one, and then go for insert, and then we want to insert a basic diagram, and it's simply a 2D one, and it immediately creates nicely the diagram that we want. So for each variable, for each movie in the cinema in this case, the percentage of visitors, and that's it.